This is a North Carolina wheat crop alert funded by the North Carolina Small Grain Growers Association. I'm Randy Weiss at NC State University, and it's December 2011. Symptoms of yellowing, unthrifty plants have been showing up in wheat fields around the state. Some of these symptoms are caused by herbicide carryover, like those shown in this picture of command damage. A second cause of yellowing wheat, especially in sandy soils, is manganese deficiencies, often the result of overliming or high soil pH. Manganese deficiencies can cause serious yield losses. If areas of yellowing wheat with stunted, unthrifty tillers are seen, diagnostic soil and tissue samples should be sent to the NCDA lab as soon as possible. If a manganese problem is diagnosed, 10 pounds of elemental manganese can be applied to the soil, or a half a pound can be applied to the foliage. Foliar applications are going to be the most effective. With the warm temperatures we've had, it's time for weed control. Our most common weedy pests, chickweed, henbit, and wild garlic, can all be controlled with Harmony Extra, which can be applied right now in December. Annual bluegrass is best controlled when small, while in the one leaf to two tiller stage, and that generally means right now. Osprey is the only herbicide we have for in-season annual bluegrass control. December is also the best time for Italian ryegrass control. Osprey, one option for ryegrass control, is most effective while the ryegrass is between one leaf and two tillers. Osprey is also most effective when mixed with 1 to 2 quarts of a non-ionic surfactant plus 1 to 2 quarts of 30% liquid nitrogen per 100 gallons of spray solution. PowerFlex is another option for ryegrass control. However, if you have Osprey-resistant ryegrass, it may also be resistant to PowerFlex. PowerFlex needs to be applied when ryegrass has fewer than 2 tillers and is most effective when 1 to 2 quarts of a non-ionic surfactant is added per 100 gallons of spray solution. Axial is a third herbicide we have for in-season ryegrass control. It also needs to be applied when the ryegrass is small. Do you need more information about herbicide carryover, manganese deficiencies, or weed control? The new Small Grain Production Guide is available from your local county extension agent and covers all of these subjects. It's also available online at www.smallgrains.ncsu.edu. And this crop update was brought to you by the North Carolina Small Grain Growers Association.